So you've been looking all over the internet for how to kill a pimple in a day, and nothing has worked. If you've been trying to do that, I'm here to tell you that really doesn't work like that. I've had a pimple for quite some time, and I've been trying to kill it. I'm going to be discussing in this video on how can you really take care of a pimple when it happens all of a sudden, and what really works and what doesn't work. If you're new to this channel, welcome, and if you're returning, welcome back. If you're new here, what you can expect is content created based on science, based on my experience in the field. I'm professionally qualified in it, and I run a business in beauty for 9 years. Today, I'm going to be talking about how can you kill a pimple in a day. It is one of the most common or the most clickbaity videos that I found on YouTube. It was both disheartening but also motivating for me to get out there and actually set the stage clear. And I have a pimple to talk about. So, first off, can you kill a pimple in a day? Here is what a pimple is. Once you understand that, you're going to be better poised to answer that question yourself. Pimple is actually sebum, oil, bacteria, basically a plug that forms in your pore. That can happen because of excess sebum. There are tons of reasons why you can have excess sebum, and that's a whole different topic. I'm just going to be talking about a pimple. Pimple is different from acne. When you have a lot of such breakouts on your face on a very regular basis, and they're full of pus, they are painful, they're scarring, that is a skin disease, and that is what we call acne. Acne can be mild, it can be moderate, and can be severe. And there are six different types of acne. So if anybody tells you they can treat your acne without understanding the kind of acne you have, please move on. They don't know what they're talking about. This video is dedicated only to a pimple. A pimple is a breakout that you get randomly. You might get it around your period. It might happen, regularly on some months, and it might disappear. Sometimes you might get two, but it never goes beyond that. And the scars are not too bad. Bacterial activity is the reason why you get redness, you get pus, and some of you might get itching and even burning or pain in that particular pimple. So can you get rid of, a pimple in a day? No, you can't do that. You can get rid of it in a day. What you can do is subdue it. And here is what really works. The first thing is, when you get pimples like this, you don't have to get into a whole overdrive and move to an anti-acne routine. You don't need to do that. A simple cleanser that you're using is good enough, because your cleanser is looking for you, remember, for the rest of the days when you didn't have this breakout. However, if you are getting a lot of these, then you might want to move to a treatment cleanser, so the cleanser might have salicylic acid in it. Otherwise, if you just have a cleanser which is non-medicated, it's completely fine. That's what I do. Since I get these very randomly, I just use non-medicated cleanser. My favorite continues to be the Innisfree Green Tea Seed Cleanser. I use it because, one, it gives you the full benefit of the double cleanse, plus it also has green tea, which is extremely calming and purifying for your skin. So it's great. If you're using a treatment-based cleanser, that's completely fine also. Because if you're getting a lot of these, and you want the salicylic to go in and clean up your pores, and so you kind of reduce the frequency of the pimples you're going to get. Post the cleanser, I then move on to something called spot treatments. Here are a few hacks which have worked for me, and I'm quite confident is going to work for you. The first thing you need to do is that the moment the pimple starts coming on, start dabbing it with tea tree oil. It's good to have your own bottle of tea tree oil. I use this one. It was given to me by a vendor, so it's really pure. You can use the one from Body Shop. It's very good tea tree oil too. And you need to dab it onto your Q stick. Just a little bit, and put it directly onto your pimple. The reason I say to hold it and dab it for some time is that you want the tea tree oil to get nicely absorbed into the pimple. But don't do it too much, in terms of don't do it too frequently. About 3 times a day is completely fine. Tea tree oil, as we know, is excellent in killing bacteria and stopping bacterial activity, and that's what we want. We want the bacteria in our pimple to kind of die. So, tea tree oil, number one. Second thing, what you can also do is use garlic. Yes, garlic was actually recommended to me by my naturopath almost 8 to 10 years back, and it works like magic. Oops. It works like magic. You need to peel it, and after you peel the garlic, you kind of smash it in a clean mortar and pestle, and the smashed garlic you take a fresh Q-tip and rub it onto the juice of the garlic. Once you have dabbed your Q-tip in the juice, you're going to apply it again the same way that you apply tea tree oil onto your acne. Keep in mind, the garlic juice is really, really potent, so do not rub it. It can give you a burn on your skin. I've had that too. So just go very, very gentle onto your pimple and keep it there for some time and let it soak in. You could do this 3 to 4 times a day if you are at home. And if you're going to work, then do it in the morning. Clean up the area before you go to work, otherwise you're going to smell of garlic. And definitely when you come back, do it once around 7:38 and then do it again before you go to bed around 8:39 or maybe 10 o'clock, whatever your time is. It's always good to use little, but use it more frequently instead of using too much, because that can burn your skin. So garlic. Third thing what really works is calming down the area. Introducing ice into that area helps a lot, because ice helps calm down the inflammation, helps bring down the redness. Just a little bit of ice onto a tissue is good enough. Make a small potli of it and put it directly onto this pimple. It really helps in calming down the inflammation. It helps in bringing down the redness dramatically. And especially if your pimple is itching, itching is basically a sign of bacterial activity. And also itching happens when the pimple is drying out, when the skin is stretching. Because you do not want to itch in that area, because that can lead to a lot of scarring. Along with all of these things, what you can also do is use collodial patches. I know that these patches come from Cosrx, but because I don't get too many of them, I don't have them at home. But if you're getting like 3-4 of them and you're working and they tend to get a little big and you feel very conscious about it, it's all right to apply those. Those patches also help in sucking out the pus and the, you know, calming down the bacteria. So they're really, really good. Cosrx is a good brand for you to go after and get the patches from. What can you do in DIY space? I know there are tons of DIY spaces, and it really, really irritates me to see some of these videos which tell you, you know, ye paste lagao and ye lagao, wo lagao, raat ko tumhara pimple gum ho jayega. You know, pimples can't disappear like that, because like we discussed, they're a lesion on your skin. It's a tear on your skin. There's bacteria on it. And these things, bacteria and tear, have a life cycle. They have to have a certain hours to cure and to stop activity. So don't bank on it too much. But what you can do is calm down the bacteria with some of the DIY. So you can take Multani Mitti. I recommend Multani Mitti, because Multani Mitti has the ability to suck out the oil and the extra sebum from that particular spot. So it really works well. With Multani Mitti, put a little bit of unboiled milk, works like a lactic acid peel. Along with that, you can add a little bit of tea tree and just dab the particular pimple. It'll help in drying it up, but also bringing down the bacterial activity of that particular pimple. So that really helps. Another DIY that really helps is using neem oil. Even with neem oil, you can mix it with your Multani Mitti and then put it over there. That also works. Even nutmeg powder works. Again, you want as little dilution in these particular ingredients. So nutmeg powder, make a fine paste out of it. You can again make a paste with curd, unboiled milk, or use a little bit of neem oil and just do a small patch. Now, once the pimple is forming and it's currently becoming bigger, please don't forget to use the moisturizer on it. Because the more hydrated your skin cells are, the better they'll be able to fight the bacterial activity and also prevent scarring. Because the more plumper the skin cell is, the less scar they get. So therefore, it's very important to keep that particular area hydrated. If you have oily skin and tend to get one or two of these, it's good to introduce niacinamide into your skincare, because niacinamide also helps in controlling sebum. What else can you do? You can also use vitamin C with naginate. I've done a whole video on this particular vitamin C from The Minimalist. The acetyl glucosamine is actually very, very good in fighting acne, because it has the ability to act almost as strongly as benzoyl peroxide does without the dryness or the stinging that BP can give you. So give that particular vitamin C a shot. Important thing with acne is to also start preventing the pigmentation or the scarring that will come with it. So as soon as you can, start introducing Azelaic to that particular spot. My favorite is the Azelaic from The Ordinary. I use it very, very often. You just need a little bit of the cream and, you know, just dab skin. It's over. What's there? A little bit of that onto your acne and leave it there for some time. And this particular cream you can actually gently rub into it. It does work very, very well in drying it up. As powerful as the Azelaic is from The Ordinary, there's something even more powerful than this, and that is the Boost from Paula's Choice. And the reason it's even more powerful is because now, along with azelaic acid, it also has salicylic acid, just the ingredient that you need to go in and clean out the pore and dry it out. And it has licorice. Licorice, of course, helps pigmentation in lightening it. So this is the product that you should have in your cupboard, because the moment you start getting this, applying this in the morning and night is absolutely brilliant in making sure you don't get too much of scarring once the pimple heals. Both of these products really help in minimizing pigmentation or PIH dramatically. So invest in these two products. But please don't forget the sunscreen. It's incredibly important to make sure that you minimize UV damage to the pimple, because the more UV damage that you have, the more pigmented that spot can get. Going overactive on a pimple is like actually disturbing a site that's trying to heal. So do not touch it, stay away from it, and do the things that are recommended. They work for me and they work quite well. And let me know once you use them how they work for you. Just so you know, I'm going to be doing a whole series of videos on acne. We're going to be discussing the different types of acne, what can you do for the different type of acne, and some of the best practices when you have acne. So stay tuned. Till I catch you next time, be good to your skin and hair.